Hello student, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Ajit Jaiswal from Department of Anthropology, Pondicherry Central University, Puducherry. Today we are going to discuss about a topic Australopithecus under paper Physical and Biological Anthropology. Student, in this module we are going to study about the different context of studying human evolution. Who are Australopithecus? What are the spatial and temporal distributions? What are the varieties of Australopithecus? What is the sequence of appearance of all these varieties? Let me give you a glimpse of information in the form of introduction. We must have remembered the Darwin's work. All of us are quite aware about the Charles Darwin and his work. After the publication of two of his famous books, first, Origin of Species by Means of Natural Selection, or The Preservation of Favored Races in the Struggle for Life, and The Descent of Man and Selection in Relation to Sex. The concept of biological evolution in general and human evolution in particular took a new direction, new turn. The later publication specifically speak about how human being evolved from lower order animal. From that time onward, scholars across the globe were in search of the fossil of the ancestor of the present day human, who were apes or ape-like. A number of pre-hominid fossils like Parapithecus, Ageopithecus, Dryopithecus, Ramapithecus, Sivapithecus, and hominid fossil like Australopithecus and Homo were discovered and are restudied in this new light. The trajectory or projection of hominid development is not straight. That is, one species or genus subsequently giving rise to the next. Here we have seen a great variation, several branching in the tree. There were times when several species of human and other hominids, they cohabited in this world. In course of evolution, a number of new variety of hominid species evolved, and some of them became extinct without evolving into a new form. There may be several reasons behind this, but some of them, what we call other, they evolved and developed into a new form. Thus, if you see the tree, or if you see the phylogenetic branching, a phylogenetic branching appear like a tree with many branches, and these branches have a specific evolutionary importance. It will give you the clear-cut connection or explanation, as well as similarities and differences, why they branched up from the earlier one based on the differences, and why they are all together moving in the same line based on the similarities. Australopithecus are southern apes. The fossil of this genus has been found between 4 million years ago, or might be even before. It has a spectrum of varieties, all of which are extinct. The member of this groups were biped with reduced teeth size, especially the canine. These two characteristic features place the group in hominid category. It is believed that one of the species of the genus Australopithecus evolved into Homo. Now let's try to find out who are Australopithecus. The word Australopithecus means southern apes. The fossil of this genus have been found from different sites of South Africa and East Africa. Australopithecus appeared in this world around 4 million years ago, or might be even before, and has a spectrum of varieties, all of which are extinct. This group of hominids used to live in this world before Pleistocene. The member of this group were biped with reduced teeth size, especially the canine. It is believed that one of the species of genus Australopithecus evolved into hominid. The different sites of South Africa like Sterkfontein, Tong, Komdraai, and from East Africa like Oldowes, Laetoli, and Lake Turkana. This group of hominid used to live in this world before Pleistocene. It is believed that these two characteristic features place the group in the hominid category, and it is one of the species of genus Australopithecus that evolved into Homo. There have been some recent discoveries of fossil from Africa like Sahelanthropus, Ororin, and Ardeopithecus that claim to be of a family hominidae. These varieties arrived in the world before the appearance of a typical variant of Australopithecus, that is, shortly after the divergence from our common ancestor with chimpanzee. They were biped but retained a number of ape-like characteristic features, probably from one of these new genera. Australopithecus evolved. So, the earliest varieties are Sahelanthropus, Ororin, Ardeopithecus. Later varieties are Australopithecus africanus, Australopithecus afarensis, which is known to be the gracile form, and Australopithecus robustus, and Australopithecus bossi as the robust form. Now we will discuss on the fossil hominid discovered so far in the chronological order of appearance in the record, except that the robust Australopithecus are kept together. First, let's discuss about Sahelanthropus. This species was discovered in 2001 from Chand in Central Africa. The word Sahel is derived from the name of the region of Africa bordering the south of Sahara, and the fossil was unearthed from this place. It is the oldest known hominid, dated between 6 and 7 million years old. The discovery of this fossil remains made the world to believe that hominid of Miocene period is not restricted in East and South Africa. However, proof et al. Challenged the hominid status of this fossil. This species is known from a nearly complete cranium and a number of fragmentary lower jaw and teeth. The brain size similar to that of an ape, but with reduced subnasal prognathism. It is popularly known as Tomai, that is, hope of life. This individual has many primitive ape-like features, such as the small brain case, along with some characteristics of later hominids, such as the position of foramen magnum and small canine teeth. This mixture, along with the fact that it comes from around the time when the hominids are thought to have diverged from chimpanzee, suggests its closeness to the common ancestors of human and chimpanzee, Ororin. This species was named in July 2001 from fossils discovered in western Kenya, dated 6 million years ago. The fossils include fragmentary arm and thigh bones, lower jaws and teeth. The limb bones are about the size of a female chimpanzee. Its finders have claimed that Ororin was a human ancestor, adapted to both bipedality and tree climbing, and that the Australopithecus are an extinct offshoot. A later study in 2004 has found further evidence of bipedality in the fossil femur. Ardeopithecus remidus, This species was discovered by a team led by Tim White and Asfa and Sua in 1994. Most remains are skull fragment. It has been dated about 4.4 to 5.8 million years. Evidence suggests that they were possibly biped and that some individuals were about 122 centimeters tall. The teeth are intermediate between those of earlier apes and Australopithecus afarensis, which is known to be the earliest form of Australopithecus. But one baby tooth is very primitive, which resembles a chimpanzee tooth more than any other known hominid tooth. More recently, a number of fragmentary fossils discovered between 1997 and 2001 and dated from 5.2 to 5.8 million years old have been assigned first to a new subspecies, that is Ardipithecus ramidus, then Kadaba, and then later as a new species Ardipithecus Kadaba. One of these fossils is a toe bone belonging to a bipedal creature, but is a few hundred thousand years younger than the rest of the fossil, and so its identification with Kadaba is not as firm as the other fossil. Now let's discuss about the later varieties, Australopithecus anamensis. In 1965, Brian Patterson and other scholar from Harvard University discovered a single arm bone of an early human at the site of Kanapoi in northern Kenya. This could not conclude anything from this discovery, since there was no supportive evidence. Later in the year 1994, Meave Leakey discovered some more fossil remains from the same site of Lake Turkana. The material consists of skull fragment, teeth and long bones. The word anam, A-N-A-M, means lake in the Turkana language. Anamensis existed between 4.2 and 3.9 million years ago and has a mixture of a primitive feature in the skull and advanced feature in the body. The teeth and jaw are very similar to those of older fossil apes. A partial tibia, the larger of the two lower leg bones, shows stronger evidence of bipedality. And a humerus, the upper arm bone, which is extremely human-like. Note that although the skull and skeletal bones are thought to be from the same species, this is not confirmed. Australopithecus afarensis. A number of fossil of this type has been discovered at different times, that is between 1975 to 1991. But Johnson and Johnson and Gray, Kimball and Reck from different places of East Africa like Hadar in Ethiopia, Letoli in Tanzania. Of this fossil remain, the one discovered from Hadar is nicknamed as Lucy, an adult female skeleton of 25 year old. Australopithecus afarensis existed between 3.9 and 3 million years ago. They had an ape-like face with a low forehead, a bony ridge over the eyes, a flat nose and no chin. They had protruding jaw with large back teeth. Cranial capacity varied from about 375 to 550 cc. The skull is similar to that of a chimpanzee, except for the more human-like teeth. The canine teeth are much smaller than those of modern apes, but larger and more pointed than those of women. And shape of the jaw is between the rectangular shape of apes and the parabolic shape of women. However, their pelvis and leg bone closely resemble modern human and leave no doubt that they were biped, although adapted to walking rather than running. A footprint in the volcanic ash from Laetoli is the oldest evidence of bipedalism among the Australopithecus. Females were substantially smaller than males, a condition known as sexual dimorphism. Height varied between about 107 cm and 152 cm. The figure and the toe bones are curved and proportionally longer than in human, but the hands are similar to human in most other detail. Most scientists considered this evidence that afferences was still partially adapted to climbing in trees. Others considered it evolutionary baggage. Canthropus platypus. A partial skull was discovered from Lomikwi in Kenya, dated about 3.5 million years. The size of the skull is similar to Australopithecus afarensis and Australopithecus africanus, and has a large flat face and a small teeth. This variety is contemporary to Lucy. Tim Voigt rejected the genus Canthropus and considered it as a variant of Australopithecus afarensis. Now let's discuss about the Australopithecus africanus. All the fossils of this variety have been discovered from South Africa. Of this, the discovery of Tongue Child, a skull of a child made by Raymond Dart in 1924. This marks the beginning of the discovery of Australopithecus. This Tongue Child, this 3-year-old child skull, is the first early human skull ever discovered in Africa. Raymond Dart claimed this fossil as an ancestor to human form. Its position of foramen magnum, which is like the modern human. Australopithecus africanus existed between 3 to 2 million years ago. It is similar to afarensis and was also biped, but the body size was slightly greater. Their brain size may also have been slightly larger, maybe ranging between 420 and 500 cc. This is a little larger than the chimpanzee brain, despite a similar body size, but still not advanced in the areas necessary for speech. They lack teeth. Teeth were little bigger than in afarensis. Although the teeth and jaw of africanus are much more larger than those of human, they are far more similar to human teeth than they are those of apes. The shape of the jaw is now fully parabolic, very similar to like human being. That's why we call it as it belongs nearer to human being. And the size of the canine teeth is further reduced compared to afarensis. Australopithecus ethiopithecus or Parapithecus ethiopithecus, called as black skull, discovered by Alan Walker in 1985 near West Turkana in Kenya. Australopithecus ethiopithecus existed between 2.6 and 2.3 million years ago. This species is popularly known as the black skull. It is so called because the manganese deposit in the soil deposit where the skull was located stained it black. It may be an ancestor of other two robust varieties of Australopithecus, that is, Robustus and Bossi, but it has a baffling mixture of primitive and advanced trait. The brain size is very small, that is 410 cc. Part of the skull, particularly the hind portion, are very primitive, most resembling afferences. Other characteristics are massiveness of the face, jaw, and single teeth tooth found, and the largest sagittal crest. Australopithecus robustus, discovered from Cromdrai, from Swartkans and Drymolen cave. All these sites are in South Africa. Australopithecus robustus had a body similar to that of Africanus, but a larger and more robust skull and teeth. It existed between 2 and 1.5 million years ago. The massive face is flat or dish with no forehead and large brow ridges. It has relatively small front teeth but massive grinding teeth in a large lower jaw. Its diet would have been mostly coarse, tough food, and that needed a lot of chewing. The average brain size is about 530 cc. Bones excavated with Robustus skeleton indicate that they may have been used as a digging tool. Australopithecus bossi or Paranthropus bossi or Gigantropus bossi. This is the most robust form of Australopithecus, discovered by Mary Leakey from Old George, Tanzania, by Richard Leakey from Lake Turkana, Kenya, and by Suwa from Ethiopia. Australopithecus bossi existed between 1.8 and 1.1 million years ago. It was similar to Robustus, but the face and cheek teeth were even more massive, some molars being up to 2 cm across. The brain size is very similar to Robustus, about 530 cc. Some scholars' opinion about bossi and Robustus to be a variant of the same species. Sequence of appearance. Thus, we see a spectrum of varieties of Australopithecus. They appeared in this world during Pleistocene epoch and were distributed mostly in South and East Africa. The question is that why the distribution of Australopithecus is restricted to East and South Africa still need to be answered. Moreover, how these varieties diversified members are related to each other and with different species of genus Human are yet to reach any consensus. Even though they have been divided by some investigator into several genera like Sahelanthropus, Ardipithecus, Australopithecus and Paranthropus, it is still unclear whether the earlier hominids were simply diverse within a widely distributed group, for example like modern human, or they represent more than any one evolutionary life. The sequence of appearance of this fossil record revealed that Sahelanthropus came around 6 to 7 million years, whereas Ororin around 6 million years, Ardipithecus around 4.4 to 4.8 million years. The gracile form of Australopithecus, that is Australopithecus afarensis and Australopithecus africanus and Australopithecus gerhi, between 4.2 to 2 million years. Kenanthropus around 3.5 million years and Paranthropus, both Robustus and Bosai, between 2.6 and 1 million years. Despite these varieties, paleoanthropologists, that is scientists who study human fossils, identify two major forms of Australopithecus, gracile and Robustus. Some of the scholars prefer to keep them in two different genera, that is Australopithecus gracile form and Paranthropus robustus form. It is believed that one of the species of the gracile form of Australopithecus evolved into genus Homo, although the robustus form appeared later than the gracile form. Now let's try to summarize this model with some of the important points, like the word Australopithecus, which means southern apes, it was discovered from different sites of South Africa. Even there we have several sites of East Africa also gave the evidence of Australopithecus. They last for around, their period is around 4 million years ago, or might be even before. We don't have that, we don't have such fossil material to explain their existence even before that, but maybe. The member of these groups were bipedal with reduced teeth size. This bipedalistic characteristics and reduced teeth size is bringing them somewhat closer to human rather than apes. And especially the canine size is very reduced, similar, more or less, not very similar, but somewhat similar to human. There is a number of earlier varieties of Australopithecus, or Australopithecus like skulls were discovered or excavated from different sites of Africa, like Sahelanthropus, Ororin, Audiopithecus. We have a even number of evidence of the later varieties also called as Australopithecus afarensis, Australopithecus africanus. This Australopithecus afarensis and africanus, they are known to be the gracile form of Australopithecus, whereas Australopithecus robustus and Australopithecus bosai, they are the robustus form. So both gracile form and robustus form the later varieties of Australopithecus. We have also number of evidences or number of material that was discovered, excavated from different places, like Sahelanthropus, it came around 6 to 7 million years ago. Ororin, it arose around 6 million years ago. Audiopithecus is about 4.4 to 4.8 million years ago. The gracile form, that include afarensis and africanus, forms of Australopithecus, they were between 4.2 to 2 million years ago. In between, there is a more or less similar but somewhat better than this one is a Kenyapithecus, is around 3.5 million years ago. We also have evidence called of a Paranthropus, both robustus and bosai. This robustus form is also called as a Paranthropus form, and it include Australopithecus robustus and Australopithecus bosai. It was between 2.6 and 1 million years ago. So it is believed that one of the species of the gracile form of Australopithecus, it evolved and evolved into a genus Homo, though the robustus form appeared later than the gracile form. Thank you.